This is a story of a young man named Jimmy who lost sight of his path, riddled by distractions and impulse. Jimmy was ambitious, hardworking, and full of curiosity. He lived in a small village with his mother and his cat Freya. He knew the time had come for him to leave his home behind and go into the world and make a name for himself. He didn't have much money, but he had enough saved to get him where he wanted to go. The city had more opportunities for Jimmy, so Jimmy bought a train ticket and packed a few of his belongings and went up to his mother and said,
"Mama, I love you very much, but I have decided to move to the city to make a name for myself."
His mother knew this day would come, and she said to Jimmy,
"I understand, mijo. All I ask is for you to be cautious with your time and your money. Spend it wisely and don't lose your focus. And remember, if all things fail, you will always have a home to come back to."
Jimmy was ready to start his new life, envisioning all the possibilities and opportunities the city had to offer. He knew that with Freya right by his side, she would keep him grounded.
Wait, what was that?
Jimmy followed the voice. The voice took him off the road and into the woods, where he quickly arrived at the bank of a river. A traveling Spanish street performer stopped by the river to take a break from the heat of the summer sun. She had a voice of a siren. Jimmy was instantly mesmerized. Freya, however, was unimpressed.
"Jimmy, yeah, we really need to go."
Jimmy suddenly realized he had lost track of time.
"Freya, we need to go. We need to go, pero ahora."
"What's the rush?"
And so, Jimmy and Freya ran. They ran as fast as they could. Jimmy and Freya finally arrived at the town where the train was soon to depart.
"We made it. We made it, Freya." "Okay, Freya, but no more distractions, vale? We need to get to the train station right away."
Freya looked at Jimmy with an annoyed expression. The town was alive. Food markets and various vendors lined every street and stretched as far as both could see. Jimmy was wide-eyed. There was so much to see, for the village he was from was small and simple.
"Vale, chaval. Ven, ven. Come into my shop. I have clothes for you."
No. I'm sorry, but I can't. I'm going to miss my train."
"A dónde va? Where are you going?"
"I'm heading to the city."
"Dressed like that?"
Jimmy suddenly felt insecure.
No, you can't go into the city dressed like that. Ben, I will give you a good deal. You need to look presentable in order for people to take you seriously."
"Well, maybe I can take a look. A quick look."
"You need your shoes. Esto la caña. This is the best leather shoes. Good shoes take you places."
"Ale, they are beautiful. I will buy them. After all, I do need new shoes." "Oh no, Freya! Our train!"
The train was departing.
"Wait! Hold the train!"
He was bumping into people.
"Hey, watch where you're going!"
"Wait, please! Para!"
Jimmy was not going to give up. He was going to get on that train. Jimmy ran towards the train, dropping all of his belongings. Jimmy and Freya missed the train.
"Freya, what are we going to do now? I don't have enough money to buy another train ticket. This is so unfair. Why does this always have to happen to me?"
Freya looked at Jimmy and said,
"Jimmy, I'm just going to tell you straight up, okay? You did this. Playing the victim is a waste of time. You were the one who stopped to listen to the chavala sing by the river. You were the one who stopped to shop. You were the one who spent the money. You were the one who got distracted. Mira, Jimmy, take accountability of your actions."
Jimmy knew Freya was right. He had failed and had to take accountability. Jimmy knew this wasn't the end. He knew he had to go back home and start over. He was going to have to work harder and save his money all over again and not repeat the mistakes he had made. Jimmy still felt disappointed in himself, but he knew his mother would welcome him home with open arms, for he had remembered what his mother had said. If all fails, he will always have a home to come back to.